everyone. Today we're gonna talk about the wine coolers and the frequently asked questions, the FAQs about the best wine cooler. And this video will be focusing on the FAQs, the most asked questions, and to let you know, we have collected the information from online stores, from forums and social media profile research and lots of stuff like this. In this video, after this video, you're gonna look at the wine coolers review, and obviously you will be presenting a discount link so that you can have a discount when you buy through that link. So moving on, the first basic questions: what's the bottle quantity you will be going for? Our research suggests that the almost even more than 90% of US people prefer the 30 bottles wine cooler. That means you can go for the 30 bottles, or you can go for even more. The second question is whether you're gonna go for the single or dual zone. You have to keep it in mind, if you are a wine collector, or if you are going to have both red and white wines, you will be needing two different temperature for keeping this wine, because both red and white versions requires separated temperature, segregated zone. Then the dual zone wine cooler will be the best choice for you. The compressor or thermoelectric versions, what will be your preferred cooling mechanism? Telling you, the compressor mechanism is visible in your refrigerators. There is a gas compressor, there is a cooling gel, and it cools the inside through the cooling gel and the compressor technique. But why thermoelectric versions are becoming so popular nowadays? Here it is. It has some advantages. Thermoelectric versions are cost effective, it's environment friendly, it does not emit just anything, it does not require additional time for coming down, it generates low vibration and noises, and there are some other positive sides. But like everything, the thermoelectric versions also do have some negative points. You have to visit my website for exploring the secrets. The basic questions: what are the types? Wine coolers are so many types of, but architecturally wine coolers are three types of: the freestanding versions, countertop versions, built-in under counter versions. Freestanding versions are just like the mini refrigerator, you can keep it anywhere of your home. The countertop version is the most smallest versions, you can keep it like in your table, in your desk, or wherever. The built-in under counter versions are the most expensive wine cooler in this world, because it has some dynamic facilities I'll be talking about just after some few slides. And obviously built-in versions are required when you are going to set the wine coolers which match your interior or your environment. Moving on, according to the cooling system, wine coolers are two types of: compressor cooling and thermoelectric cooling. I have already discussed it just a minute earlier. And according to the zone, the wine coolers are more than two types of. So what is the zone? Single zone wine coolers just have a single temperature zone. The dual zone wine cooler have two different temperature zones, so that you can keep your red and white wines at a differentiated temperature. Or if you need something bigger than this, triple and quad zone wine coolers are also available in the market. The funny questions: can you use a freestanding wine cooler as a built-in wine cooler? Conceptually you cannot, but technically yes you can. If your wine cooler have air ventilation from the front, you can keep it anywhere. But if your wine cooler do not have the air ventilation from the front, that means you have to leave some some space behind it or in left or right side, which might not feasible or which might not appears to be sturdy. So look in the picture, the right images has the air circulation from front, and the left image just have not. What will be your perfect temperature for wine? Here's the evidence. The light dry white wines, roses, sparkling wines are served at between 40 degree to 50 degree Fahrenheit, and the others are served between 50 degree to 60 degree Fahrenheit. And that's why you need a dual zone wine cooler if you are going to own the variety of wine bottles. What makes it worst? You have to know these facts, because if you do not know what features makes a wine cooler worse, you are just not going to evaluate what will be your best product. First, you have to look at whether the thing you are buying have adjustable shelves or not, because if it do not have any adjustable shelf, you are not going to keep an already opened bottle in it. And again, all wine bottles are not the same. It varies from taste, version, or upon the company. So you need to have an adjustable shelf so that you can easily adjust it according to your bottle size and the condition. The wine cooler is a wine chiller. It's not a wine refrigerator. There are some differences. The wine cooler works for you, like it keeps your wine at an optimum serving temperature so that the taste become as good as it was and as good as it should be. But let's check whether the wine cooler you are going to buy, whether it generates or mount ice inside of it. If it does, then definitely the taste of your wine might deteriorate. And then the big questions: what other features you are going to look for? Number one, let's see whether the wine cooler have the lock facility or not, because you will not allow your toddler to touch your vintage collections. You will not allow anybody you don't like to touch your vintage collections, and obviously you need to have a proper control of your collections. Number two, check whether the wine cooler you're going to buy has an automatically temperature controlling zone, because you have to set the temperatures for both zone. And again you need to have automatic memory function to restore previously set a temperature when your electricity shuts down, because if it does not this minimum thing for you, you're gonna lose the taste of your wine. And finally, check whether the wine cooler have a tinted UV, that means ultraviolet protection glass, because direct sunlight, the UV rays can hamper the taste of your wine. And then check the shelf. Look at this picture, it's sturdy, it's wooden. The wooden shelf will not generate noises or vibrations for you. The structure, this layout often ensures the maximum utilization of available space. And obviously don't forget to check whether the shelf is adjustable or not. The end of my video, I guess you like it. And don't forget to visit the website www.nippywine.com, and in this video in this website we have published some wine cooler reviews, and there are some discount link, and you're gonna avail some discount from the online shopping if you go through my website and go through my link. Thank you. If you have liked it, please do place on shares, because your sharing will be a gift from your side as well. And if you have any specific query, do not forget to leave a comment or feedback. Definitely I'll be coming up with some new ideas or new secrets. Till then, bye bye, good luck, thank you.